Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord is God. It is he that made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generation. Pray. Gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we praise you and thank you for this morning. Thank you for giving us yet another opportunity to come together in your holy sanctuary and to praise your holy name, to adore your name, and to lift your name on high, O Master. At this moment, O Lord, we are thankful to you for who you are in our lives and for the things what you do in our lives. We adore you, O Master Lord. We give you thanks with our whole heart. We praise your holy name at this moment, O Lord. Thank you for adding one more new day in our lives. It is purely by your grace and your grace alone, O Lord, that we are alive. Thank you for adding each new day in our lives and, Lord, enabling us to worship you and to adore you, O Master. As a church, we come to your throne of grace, O Lord, and surrender our lives into your mighty care. The reason we live is to worship you alone, O Master Lord. And it is our privilege and it is our opportunity to adore your name. At this moment, O Lord, as a church, as we have gathered here, we thank you and praise you, O Lord. We give you glory and honor. You are worthy of our praises, O Master Lord, as we have gathered here in your name. Help us to worship you in truth and in spirit, O Master Lord. Help us to love you with all our hearts, with all our souls, with all our strength and with all our minds, O Master. Be present amidst of us, O Lord, as you have promised. Where two or three are gathered in my name, I will be there in their midst. Heavenly Father, strengthen your congregation. As we sing praises, meditate upon your holy word, pray for our needs and partake in different aspects of the worship, O Master. Consecrate us and make us worthy to worship you. Not by our might, but by your spirit, O Lord. You are the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. You take control of the worship service and you receive glory, honor, power and praise and bless us, O Lord, through this service. We surrender our lives into your mighty care and this time of worship. And we pray this prayer in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us all rise and sing hymn number 17, hymn number 17. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder... Hymn number 17, hymn number 17.
O Lord, my God, when I
As we are in the presence of the Lord, it is right and appropriate to worship God by singing a few choruses. Let us also acknowledge that He is worthy to be praised. He is our Creator, He is our Lord, He is our Master, and we are His creation. In Psalms 95, it says, "Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before Him with thanksgiving and extol Him with music and song." At this moment, I would request the worship team to come forward and lead us in the time of singing and praise.
It's a good thing to be in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Are you all happy this day? Hallelujah. The Word of God says, you know, worship the Lord with the beauty of His holiness. So let's all worship Him today with the beauty of holiness. Let's all look down to God and just call Him and invite His holy presence. Let's all bow down our heads and look up to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. We come before Your throne, O God, with fear, with reverence, that He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. The Creator of heaven and earth is here among us, the Holy One of Israel, the Almighty God, the Creator of you and me. He is here with us. Hallelujah. We worship Him. We worship. Let's all worship Him. Let's all worship Him. Worship Him. Worship Him with the beauty of His holiness. Oh, we worship You, Lord God. We humble ourselves and we come to You, Lord God, to the throne of grace, where we will be strengthened, O God, where we will be renewed, O Master God. For You are the God who will refresh us, O Lord God, as we come to Your throne. Thank You, Lord God, for calling us as your children, O God, and we call you as Abba Father. When we are weak, O Master God, you are our strength, O Lord God Jesus. Oh, you are so much precious, O God. Hallelujah. What a joy to have Him as our God. Yes, church. Let's all sing this song. You are my strength when I'm weak.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my all in all. Seeking you as a precious jewel. To give up, I'd be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus.
Down for the joy of the Lord.
yes, Lord, amen. I'm pressed but not pressed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I'm blessed beyond the curse, for His promise will endure, and His joy is gonna be my strength. Though the sorrow may last for the night, His joy comes in the morning. Oh, I'm trading my sorrows, I'm trading my shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing, holy, holy, holy.
Just what to do.
And I
all my days. Hallelujah.
Christos, what a joy to be in His presence. Yes, church. Just humble yourself and give to the Lord. For God resists the proud, but He gives grace to the humble. Let's all bow down our heads. For no one is greater here than our God. For He is Almighty King of Kings and Lord of Lords, the Creator of heaven and earth. For we are His people. We are His sheep in His hands. For He knows everything from the day of your birth until now. The day we formed in our mother's womb, He calls out by name. For He is Almighty God and He is the most powerful God that we are worshipping. Let's worship Him with fear and trembleness. By His voice, everything will shatter. For He is loving and He is kind. He is so much compassionate towards us. Let's all humble ourselves before Him right now. For this is the time that God has given us in our lives. Humble before Him right now. Surrender our lives. Let's all surrender our lives to Him. For He will make everything new. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Open up your mouth and say hallelujah. For our God reigns. He reigns in our lives. He reigns in our home. He reigns in our workplaces. Allow Him to reign in your heart. Hallelujah.
And I will love you, Lord, my shield.
He's my strength, yes.
And I will love you, Lord, my shield. Yes, I will love you, Lord, my rock. Forever all my days, I will love you.
That to worship you, Lord Jesus. For you are such a great God, Lord God. Yet you are so much humble, Lord, that you gave your Son for us to die on the cross, to shed His blood for us, to cleanse us all from our sins and from all our iniquities. And through your blood, Lord Jesus, we are called by your children, like your children, O Master God. And we call you Abba Father, O Master God. Thank you for redeeming us, Lord, by your blood. And thank you for renewing us, O Master God, and strengthening us. And filling us, Lord Jesus, with mercy and goodness, Lord God. Thank you, Almighty God. We worship you. We worship you. Thank you, Jesus God. Thank you for giving us this wonderful time to stand in your presence and give ourselves to you. Thank you for accepting us, O Lord God, as a living sacrifice. Thank you, Jesus. Hold us and lead us, O Lord, in coming days. In Jesus' most matchless name, I ask this prayer, O God. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, I may be seated in God's presence.
As we go to the intercession, as I lead in the pastoral prayer, let us remain in the attitude of praying. Let us remain in the attitude of worshiping God. and seeking His face for our beloved ones, for our society, for our nation, and for all those who love us. Loving our neighbor is an essential component of loving our God. As we remain in the presence of the Lord, let us intercede. As the music is being played, the altar of the Lord welcomes us to come to His presence and to surrender our lives and to give our lives in control of God. It is not we, it is not our efforts, it is not our knowledge, it is not our social economic positions. It is purely by our grace, God's grace, that we are given this privilege to come through His throne, to confess our sins, to pray, and to see His hand upon us. As the music is being played, I would request those who are led by the Spirit to come forward and pray in the presence of the Lord. Let us pray. Gracious, our loving Heavenly Father, we come to You humbling ourselves and giving You thanks. We love You, Lord. We acknowledge that You are our Creator, You are our Master, You are our Redeemer. You are the one who loved us before we loved us, loved You, O Master. We are the vilest offenders, sinners. We have sinned against You and You alone, O Master. Yet, O Lord, You have cleansed us thoroughly through the precious blood of Your Son, Jesus Christ. And You have made us holy, acceptable, O Lord, in Your sight. Thank You for this wonderful privilege to be called Your sons and Your daughters. With that privilege and position, we come to You, O Master, Lord, calling You Abba, Father. Lord, You are our Father. You are the one who provides for each one of our needs. You have been Jehovah Jireh in our lives, O Lord. We thank You for that. You are the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. And Lord, we acknowledge that You are in control of our lives. We are nothing, O Lord, yet through Your love, You have saved us and You have redeemed us. Thank You, O Lord. And at this moment, we confess that we are sinners. And Lord, as David prayed, we also pray that, Lord, have mercy on us, O God. According to Your unfailing love, according to Your great compassion, blot out all our transgressions. Wash away all our iniquities and cleanse us from our sins, O Master Lord. Lord, for we know our transgressions and our sins are always before us. Against You, You only have we sinned and done what is evil in Your sight. Lord, at this moment we pray that Heavenly Father, be compassionate, be kind, and forgive all our sins, O Master Lord. At this moment, O Lord, we surrender our lives. Thank You for the gift of life. Thank You for good health. Thank You for the gift of family which You have blessed each one of us with. We praise You and thank You for each and every member of our family. It is purely by Your grace that we are alive, we are happy, and we are peaceful. At this moment, O Lord, we thank You for our family. Bless each one of them. As we venture out in various activities and different endeavors, we pray that Heavenly Father, let Your hand be upon each one of us. Let Your protective hand guide us, protect us, and sustain us, O Master Lord. We especially pray and surrender this Sarjapura Road Methodist Church. And thank You for inviting us into this fellowship, O Master Lord. As we fellowship together in the company of believers, we pray and surrender our lives. We pray and commit each one of us, O Lord. As we spend few moments in worshiping You, in adoring You, build us, O Lord, build us through Your love. Unite us, bind us through Your love and Your grace, O Master Lord, so that as a church, we set an example to this society, and by our love, that people may know that we are Christians, O Master Lord. We are like Christ-like people, O Master Lord, in our works, deeds, and action. At this moment, O Lord, we especially thank You for this congregation. You have established this church, and we know that You are in control of this church, O Master Lord. We are a small group, yet, Lord, we know that You are present amidst of us. You are in control of each one of our lives. As You promised, Lord, I will build My church. And, Lord, You build Your church. And Lord, you inspire each one of us to be co-workers in building your kingdom, O Master. At this moment, O Lord, we especially pray for the little children of this congregation. Bless each one of them as you have promised and as you have blessed them, O Lord. At this moment, we pray that, Lord, let your blessings be abundant in their lives as they go to schools. We pray that, Heavenly Father, you give them your grace and your mercy, your knowledge, your wisdom, your power and strength, O Master Lord. As they engage in various activities, let your protective hand be upon them and protect them from all the perils and all the dangers, O Master Lord. Help them to love you and, Lord, lead a life which is pleasing unto thy sight, O Master Lord. Give them your knowledge, as your word says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge and wisdom, O Master. We pray, Lord, as the children grow in your presence, give them your knowledge and your wisdom. Help them to excel in their studies. Help them to bring glory and honor to your name and as well as for the parents, O Master. We especially pray for the youngsters, the youth of this congregation. Bless each one of them. As many of them are into professional courses, as many of them are looking for jobs and for alliances, we pray and surrender each one of them. Help them to lead a life which is right in your sight, O Master Lord. Help them to set an example in purity, in speech, and in conduct, O Master Lord, so that people may see them and glorify your name. We especially pray for the ones who are looking for job. We pray that, Heavenly Father, you give them the right job and resources to take care of themselves and the families. We especially pray for the ones who are looking for alliances. You yourself bring them the right partners in their lives, O Lord, Master. Unite them through marriage, O Lord. Bless them through their families, O Master Lord, so that they can acknowledge your presence, your hand in their lives and glorify your name, O Master. We especially pray for the women of this congregation. Bless each one of them. Give them your grace and mercy as they take care of their families, as many of them are into different professions. We pray that, Heavenly Father, let your hand be upon them. You be their rock fortress and you be their guide, O Master Lord. Give them extra portion of your grace so that they can carry on the responsibilities which you have entrusted upon each one of them, O Master Lord. We especially pray and thank you for their lives, their engagement in ministry as they strive towards building this church, O Master Lord. Bless their work of their hands and reward them according to your will and purposes, O Master Lord. At this time, we especially pray for men of this congregation. Bless each one of them as they carry on the responsibilities, as they take care of their families, as they venture out in various professions and, Lord, businesses. We pray and surrender them into your mighty care. Bless the handiworks of them, O Master Lord. Bless their families, bless their professions, bless their resources, O Master Lord, so that they can glorify your name in and through their lives, O Master. We especially pray for the senior citizens and elders of this congregation. At this juncture of their lives journey, we pray and surrender them, Lord, as they are weak and fragile. We pray that, Heavenly Father, you be their strength, you be their master, you be the one who provides for all their needs, O Master Lord. You give them extra portion of your grace so that they can live for long and glorify your name and teach the young generation your faithfulness, your goodness, and your mercies, O Master Lord. At this moment, O Lord, we especially pray for the sick ones who are suffering from various illnesses and sicknesses. We pray and surrender them into your mighty care. Jehovah Rapha, one who heals, stretch forth your healing hand upon them and heal them completely, O Lord. Restore them to good health so that they can testify your wondrous deeds in their lives, in the congregation and in fellowship, O Master. At this moment, O Lord, we surrender each one of them, those who are bedridden. We pray that, Heavenly Father, let your gracious, compassionate hand be upon them, O Master Lord. Give them your grace, your mercies, O Master Lord. You be their God and, Lord, protect them from all the dangers, O Master. We especially pray for our church, Methodist Church in India, especially remembering Bangalore Regional Conference, its district superintendents, all the evangelists, lay preachers, and all the persons who are involved in various kinds of ministry, O Master Lord. Help us to lead a life which is pleasing unto you. Help us to set an example by our word, deed, and action, O Master Lord. Help us to duly carry all the tasks and the responsibilities in conducting the sacraments, in conducting the worship services, O Master Lord. Help us to be faithful. Help us to be accountable and transparent in everything we do, O Master Lord, so that people may see our good works and glorify your name. Help us to be the salt and the light of this world, O Master Lord. Help us to set an example for many, O Lord. Help us to be, Lord, beneficial to many people who seek your face, O Master. We especially pray and surrender Koramangala Methodist Church pastoral team. Especially we surrender our senior pastor, Reverend Matthew George, assistant pastors, Reverend Ezra Naveen Daniel, Reverend Peter George, and myself, O Lord. We surrender our lives into your mighty care, Lord. Fill us with thy Holy Spirit. Give us your extra portion of your grace, your strength, and your courage to face the challenges in the ministry, O Master Lord. Give us your Holy Spirit, Lord. Help us to be filled with the Holy Spirit and carry on the responsibilities which you have entrusted to each one of us. At this moment, O Lord, we especially pray for all the institutions under Methodist Church. We pray and surrender its leaders, principals, and head of the institutions, O Master. Lord, help us to radiate Christ's love, Christ's characteristics in and through our work, O Master Lord, so that people may benefit out of our education and social services, O Master Lord. We surrender our lives, O Master Lord. At this moment, O Lord, be with us throughout this service. And Lord, you be glorified in and through all the aspects of our service, O Master. We surrender our lives and we pray this prayer in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray while we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive our trespasses as we also forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever and ever. Amen. As we are in the presence of the Lord, let us now listen to the scripture portion for this morning meditation. The scripture portion has been taken from Acts of Apostles, chapter 6, verses 1 to 5. Acts of Apostles, chapter 6, verses 1 to 5.
The epistle reading is taken from Acts, chapter 6, verses 1 to 5. I'm reading from the NIV. The choosing of the 7. In those days, when the number of disciples was increasing, the Hellenistic Jews among them complained against the Hebraic Jews because their widows were being overlooked in the daily distribution of food. So the 12 gathered all the disciples together and said, "It would not be right for us to neglect the ministry of the word of God in order to wait on tables. Brothers and sisters, choose 7 men from among you who are known to be full of the Spirit and wisdom. We will turn this responsibility over to them and will give our attention to prayer and the ministry of the word." This proposal pleased the whole group. They chose Stephen, a man full of faith and of the Holy Spirit, also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas from Antioch, a convert to Judaism. Here ends the reading.
Praise be to God. Let us pray. Our Father, we come to Thee this morning and we feel within our hearts our own deficiency when it comes to this matter of prayer. We come to know that some of the greatest men of God who have ever lived on this earth have confessed that prayer has been one of the most difficult struggles and battles in their lives. At this moment, O Lord, as we meditate upon what happens when the church prays, give us your knowledge, your wisdom, and power to understand from your scriptures and to get encouragement from your holy word, O Lord. Speak to us, O Lord, for we, your servants, are listening. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our rock, our redeemer. Amen. Kindly be seated. This entire month of August, we had been focusing on building church through fasting and prayer. And we have seen and we have dwelt on the importance of fasting and prayer in many occasions. This morning I would like to focus on what happens when we pray together as a church. And there are many cliches within our church which most of us are familiar with. One of them is that prayer changes things. Prayer changes things. Prayer changes people. Prayer definitely changes churches. This morning, let us look briefly from Acts chapter 4, chapter 6, and chapter 12, the three important things which will happen when we pray as a church. When we pray, we see two kinds. One is personal prayer, the family prayers or the individual prayers which we do at home. And the second one is the corporate prayer. God is present in both of these things. And God says when all of us come in one accord, when we are united, when we have the same spirit and same thing in our minds, when we pray, God will definitely answer. And we know that when two or three are gathered in my name, ask whatever you want, God will grant. It is essential for us as a growing church, as a small congregation, as we are looking towards striving the building the kingdom of God, striving towards building the kingdom of God, it is essential for us to consider prayer, especially today I'll be focusing on the corporate prayer, which is essential for the church. We see three things that happens when we pray. The first thing we see is when the church prays together, we become united. Unity is seen. Acts chapter 4, verses 23 or 25, if you have time, kindly read Acts chapter 4 when you go home and meditate upon this. This is a situation where Peter and John are invited in front of the Sanhedrin, and then they're asked why they are preaching about Jesus Christ and why are they prophesying or proclaiming the gospel. And they said not to do this. And these people, they still continued and they were put in the prison. When they were put in the prison, Peter and John, they were in the prison praising God, singing like Paul and Silas. The church came to know the news. All of them, they gathered together and they prayed. And because of their prayer, we know that they were released. They were released from the prison. If you have time, please read Acts chapter 4, verses 23 onwards. On their release, Peter and John went back to their own people and reported all that the chief priests and elders had said to them. When they heard this, they raised their voice together in prayer to God. Sovereign Lord, they said, you made the heaven and the earth and the sea and everything in them. You spoke by the Holy Spirit through the mouth of your servant, our father David. Why do the nations rage and the peoples plot in vain? The kings of the earth take their stand and the rulers gather together against the Lord and against his anointed ones. The church, as described by Luke in this book of Acts, is absolutely, we find it's a united church. Luke uses 10 times in Acts the Greek word to mention that the church was united. The church was on the same page. They were on the same agenda. They were one in mind, and they were able to achieve things. When we see that, they all walked according to God in unity, according to his plan and purpose in unity, so that we see many people were added. We see 1,000, we see 3,000 people, and many more new believers came towards the salvation, towards God. Many a times when we think about our churches today, we see that we have different programs. Our prayers have been substituted by programs. Our commitments with other things. For a church to build, for a family to build, the most important foundation is prayer. We forget about prayer and we plan what programs can a church have. The church is empty, only Sundays we are gathering, only Saturdays we are gathering. Let us have programs throughout the week. We have programs to do outside the church and inside the church. But this morning, as SRMC, the encouragement from God's word for us is that when we pray together, God will do things. first thing first and other things secondary. The essential thing as a family and as a church is to pray, praying unitedly. As a family, all of us should pray together for one purpose or one cause, one thing which we need. As a church, when we pray for that one cause, as God has promised, ask and it shall be given. Seek and you shall find. Knock and the door shall be open. Unless as a church we ask, it is not that God doesn't give. God will give, but He wants us to ask. As parents, we know, unless our child comes and asks, Papa, I need a cycle. I need a chocolate. We know that our son needs a cycle, bicycle. We know our son needs a chocolate, but we will not give unless we ask. It is essential for us to pray and ask God with unity, with one accord, and God will definitely grant the desires of all our hearts when we pray. As a church, prayer is essential, and being united in prayer is most essential. With one accord, when we pray, God will definitely answer. The second point which I would like to bring to your notice is that when the church prays, we receive divine direction, guidance in our families and in our churches. The scripture portion read to us, Acts chapter 6, verses 1 to 5, it talks about the confusion, the chaos existed in the church. The confusion, chaos was the widows were neglected because they are the Gentile widows, and they are the widows who were exiled and they have come back to Jerusalem city now. The Jewish widows, they were neglected in the distribution of the welfare measures or schemes in the church. In this context, people said, let us now pray and let us now select 7 people to do this job. And we see that Peter and other apostles replied that we must obey God rather than men. So they went seeking God's face. They went seeking God's guidance. They went seeking God's direction in the life of the church. And we know that when they prayed, God told them to select 7 people. The Holy Spirit led them to select these 7 servants as an example to solve the problem in the church. In the functioning of the church, many of us face these kind of difficult situations. And we go to people, we go to our leaders, we go to different influential people. Those who are rich and those who are politically strong, we go to them and we seek their guidance, their strategies to solve the problem in the church. When a church faces these kind of situations, we get an encouragement from Acts chapter 6 that we are called to seek God's direction through prayer, and it is very essential. Jeremiah chapter 29 verses 11, it says, it has never been God's plan for His people to grope around in the darkness, trying to feel their way through life and ministry. I repeat, it has never been God's plan for His people to grope around in darkness, trying to feel their way through life and ministry. Many a times when a church faces difficult situation, when our families are in a critical crisis situation, we tend to search light in the darkness. We tend to feel, and we say, I don't feel like praying. I don't feel like going to church. We give importance to our feeling rather than seeking God's face. Whether it is our life, whether it is our ministry, many of us, we say, I don't feel like engaging. I don't feel like attending. I don't feel like coming to this study or fellowship. Most of us do 2 things where our prayers are not answered or we don't find direction. One is that we don't ask God, and second thing, we wait till we mess up things and then we seek God's face. Whereas in Acts chapter 6, we see the church, when they came to know there is some problem in the church, the first thing they did is they went to the presence of God. They asked, before messing up things, they went to God's presence and they asked for divine direction. As a family, as a church, it is a reminder for us, before doing anything, before messing up things and then going to God, the first and the foremost thing should be going on our knees and praying and asking God's direction, asking God's divine intervention in our lives and seeking His face. We see in Acts chapter 6 that over 1,000 people were led to Jesus, and the disciples were overwhelmed so much that they did not have time to pray and to devote themselves to prayer. They wanted other things to take place rather than prayer and other things. So Peter says, leave us separately. Leave us, don't disturb us to engage in distribution of these welfare things to widows. Leave us alone so that we can pray and then we can minister to God rather than doing anything. So they selected 7 people. If we need divine guidance, we have to go on our knees. We have to go to the presence of God and seek His face. Acts chapter 2 verses 42 talks about the church, early church, how they function. When we read Acts chapter 2 verses 42, it says, all the believers, verse 42, they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and to the fellowship and to breaking of the bread and to prayer. These are the 4 essential things as an early church they did it. And some of the translations, it says they did it every day. Continuously they devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching, to the fellowship, to the breaking of bread, and to prayer. Many a times as a church, we do all these things, but we do it occasionally. But God's word says we have to do it continuously. And these are 4 essential pillars, or the strong pillars on which the early church stood. And we know what are the miracles they did. And you know they were casting demons, they raised dead, and the lame walked, the blind saw. And we know many Gentile people transformed their lives and they accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. When we pray as a church, as a united church, God will do these miracle things only if we do these things continuously. Devoting ourselves to apostles' teaching, in fellowshipping, breaking of bread, and to prayer. When we pray, God will work miracles. God will give us the future direction for our church. When we practice prayer as a lifestyle in our lives, God will definitely do miracles in our lives. Once many missionaries were asked different questions. Even the Billy Graham's ministry, Billy Graham was asked, what is the secret behind your ministry? So they said, when I preach on the pulpit, you go and see my wife, what she does. While I'm on pulpit, she's on her knees praying for my ministry, for my preaching. For that God's word would touch individuals' hearts and souls, that they would be transformed. George Muller, who is known as a great prayer warrior of all times, he was asked this. He said, it is a common temptation of Satan to make us give up the reading of the word and prayer. When our enjoyment is gone, as if it were of no use to read the scripture, when we do not enjoy them, and as if it were no use to pray when we have no spirit of prayer. The truth is that in order to enjoy the word, we have to continue to read it. And the way to obtain a spirit of prayer is to continue praying. The less we read the word of God, the less we desire to read it. And the less we pray, the less we desire to pray. Dear people of God, dear SRMC members, it is my humble request and encouragement to each one of us. Let us be continuous. Let us maintain this continuity in praying, whether it is a family prayer, whether it is a church. Albert Einstein in 1952, he was delivering a lecture in the campus of Princeton University. A doctoral student came to him and he asked him, I want to do my research in some field. Would you kindly suggest me to select a topic? Without thinking twice, he said, find out about prayer. Somebody who is willing to do research on prayer should take up this and find the effectiveness of prayer. And we know how people have been influenced through prayer. Paul was the one who understood the importance of prayer. Prayer is power, and we know he wrote many letters in the New Testament, and he was able to heal many people. We know Daniel. We know Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. They prayed continuously 3 times. Whatever the situation, Jesus also prayed. Whether it was his baptism, whether it was his crucifixion, he prayed and he prayed. We cannot be good Christians unless we pray. We cannot have good marriages without talking to our spouses. In the same way, we cannot be good Christians without communicating, without praying to God. It is a pipeline of communication between us and God, between God and the people who love him. Praying persistently is very essential. Paul begins to say, devote yourselves to prayer. He says, pray without ceasing. It is essential for us to pray without ceasing. Jesus also emphasized on this fact that we have to pray. And pray with passion. And we know active and passive. When God blesses us, we are very active. And when we have some critical situations in our lives, we tend to, for the sake of praying, that is a passive way of communicating to God. S.T. Gordon, in his book, Quiet Talks on Prayer, says, how much prayer meant to Jesus, it was not only his regular habit, but his resort in every emergency. However slight or serious, when perplexed, he prayed. When hard pressed by work, he prayed. When hungry for fellowship, he found it in prayer. He chose his associates and received his messages upon his knees. If tempted, he prayed. If criticized, he prayed. If fatigued in body or wearied in spirit, he had recourse to his one unfailing habit of prayer. Prayer brought him unmeasured power at the beginning and kept the flow unbroken and undiminished. There was no emergency, no difficulty, no necessity, no temptation that would not yield to prayer. Dear beloved people of God, when we pray, prayer opens the gates of heaven. Prayer gives direction. Prayer enables us to experience God's glory in our lives. Prayer enables us to pour out our hearts, and prayer enables us to seek God's direction in our lives. This leads to my third point. When we pray as a church, God's power is released. Acts chapter 12, we see that the church was facing a tough time. Herod has arrested a number of Christians. One was John's brother, that is James. He was beheaded. And now he wanted to arrest Peter, and he wants to do the same thing with Peter. When we read Acts chapter 12, verses 5 onwards, we see that Herod wanted to behead Peter. And we know, as a church, I read from verse 5, so Peter was kept in prison, but the church was earnestly praying to God for him. The night before Herod was to bring him to trial, Peter was sleeping between two soldiers, bound with two chains, and sentries stood guard at the entrance. Suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared, and a light shone in the cell. He struck Peter on the side and woke him up. Quick, get up, he said, and the chains fell off Peter's wrists. Then the angel said to him, put on your clothes and sandals. And Peter did so. Wrap your cloak around you and follow me. And the angel told him. Peter followed him out of the prison, but he had no idea that what the angel was doing was really happening. He thought that he was seeing a vision. They passed the first and the second guards and came to the iron gate leading to the city. It opened for them by itself, and they went through it. When they had walked the length of one street, suddenly the angel left him. Then Peter came to himself and said, "Now I know, without a doubt, that the Lord sent his angel and rescued me from Herod's clutches and from everything the Jewish people were anticipating." Dear people of God, when we pray as a church, God's power is released. He redeems us. He breaks every chain. He releases us from all the captives. The reason for releasing is that the church prayed earnestly. When they heard that Peter was in the prison, the first thing the church did was they prayed. And due to their prayer, the answer was that the angel of the Lord came to Peter and he was released. Dear people of God, if we want to see miracles in our lives, in our church, prayer is the essential key tool for each one of us. When we pray, definitely he will release us. We have seen Daniel. We have seen David was rescued from Saul. We know, as the worship leader was saying, the Jericho wall was brought down. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, they walked in fire, but they were not harmed. God who parted the Red Sea, God who saved Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego from fire, the God who brought down Jericho, the God who saved David from Saul, the God who opened the eyes of the blind, made lame to walk, the dumb to speak, raised Lazarus from the dead, will do the same thing for you and me when we pray. Two mistakes we do: we don't ask and we don't believe. James chapter 4 verses 1 to 3, it says, "What is causing quarrels and fights among you? Don't they come from the evil desires at war within you?" Many a times as a church, when we find, even in Galatians chapter 5, we see that the church was split because of gossips, because of the evil desires in us, which is waging war always within us. When we pray, we do not give room for all these things. When we don't pray, we tend to give space for all these things, and we know our spiritual maturity is gone, is taken, is at stake. To pray, a praying church, as there is a saying, a family that prays together stays together. This morning, I would add, or I would give a different version of it: a church that prays together will stay always united together. Praying is important for us. As a church, let us take this as a challenge. Let us take this as a challenge in our spiritual journey and pray without ceasing. This morning, I would like to leave with a few questions for us to think, ponder, and reflect from God's word. The question is the church in the book of Acts any different from that of the church we are worshiping today? The God they prayed to is the same God are we praying to? The God who shook them will definitely shake us. The God who filled them with the Holy Spirit will definitely fill us. Are we willing to surrender our lives? Whenever we are spiritually weak, let us come to the presence of God. Commit ourselves to God and commit ourselves to the body of Christ in his service. May God bless us all through this short thought from Acts. Let us pray. Gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we praise you and thank you. Many a times, O Lord, as a church, we have gone astray and we have given importance to many other things rather than praying. This moment, O Lord, thank you for encouraging us through the Acts of Apostles, through the lives of early church, to the lives of your disciples, O Master Lord, that prayer is an essential component in our lives. Help SRMC to have prayer as a strong pillar to build our church, O Master Lord. Help each individuals, as we build our families, prayer to be utmost important component in our lives, O Master Lord. Many a times, O Lord, we have gone astray and we have failed against you, O Master Lord. Help us, O Master Lord, to understand the importance of prayer, communicating with you, knowing the divine direction, staying united, and Lord, to seek your power through prayer, O Master Lord. Exhort and encourage us to see what happens when a church really prays together. For we ask these things to the glory and exaltation of our Lord Jesus Christ, whom we love and serve. Amen. Let us receive the benediction in faith. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God the Father, and sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us from now and forever. Amen.
Amen. Amen.